Your mind, you're down by a couple goals. Mm-hmm. You can't seem to crack that goalie.
Yeah.
What do you try to do in that situation? Just a lot of fakes and a lot of.
Their goalie was incredible. Yeah. She had. I think she could have like stood on top of her head and it, she would have saved it. She was on fire. Really tough goalie to get around. Good high and low. So I mean, our message once we found out we were playing St. Paul's was to try to move her as best as we can. But she really held strong. So. We scored the amount we needed to score, but I think we were like 5 for 25. So she had a great game, really credit to her and to their defense for making the shots we were putting on cage difficult.
I remember you saying, it may have been like 15 minutes left in the game, and you just told him, hey, you gotta move her. You gotta take this seriously, because she's not gonna give nothing high,
yeah.
She's not gonna give nothing low. You gotta just misdirection, just get her.
Yeah, and then we had a tough shooting day, but what I'm really proud of them for is that they kept shooting.
Mm-hmm.
You're not gonna get by her by stopping shooting. So they kept shooting, and they made the number that they needed to make.
Right. Obviously, it's a huge emotional thing after last season, what happened. And, I mean, I don't even want to imagine what they'd be like if they lost the game in that kind of fashion. But how big is this kind of game here?
It's awesome, you know, for the girls to come full circle. This has been their goal in the back of their mind all year. And we only really started talking about, like, winning the championship after our win on Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
And so they've had a great, great grit and determination throughout the season. And, you know, we were down by 2 with, I think, 4 or 5 minutes left.
Definitely.
And having been down before this year, I think that helped us because they were calm, cool, collected, and they knew what to do. So I'm incredibly proud of their resiliency, their determination, and them not hitting the panic button when a lot of other teams would have.
Yeah, talk about your seniors, Julia, Blair, Shetty coming up. They came up big when they needed to.
Yeah.
Talk about them.
Yeah, I mean, Blair at the end of the game was like, I want the shot.
Mm-hmm.
So you love having that confidence from your seniors.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of all of our seniors and upperclassmen on the field in particular just put the team on their backs. You know, that comes with experience. It comes with that drive to win.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm proud of them that they have developed into such strong women that they can have the confidence to do that and put that pressure on themselves.
I'm going to make you be a little selfish. When you left the field at US Lacrosse last year after the game, after all the tears, did you think you would be here?
No. I hadn't gotten a job at that point, so I
didn't
know.
Were you thinking about it? Were you thinking about it, though? Were you thinking about it?
The competitor in me, even as a coach, getting back here, even though I couldn't play, that was a goal that our staff had for our kids.
Mm-hmm.
But this is a real credit to them. They trusted us, trusted the process, came to practice every day with an incredible attitude, learned from their mistakes, and continued to grow throughout the year. And they won this, not me.
All right, great. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.